we're back with another episode. This is On the Run. I just got back from a run and it got me thinking about consistency is key. So if you are an all or nothing person like me, growing up, it was always like I had to be fiercely, intensely on or fiercely, intensely off. And this is when it comes to energetic time management, which is something I teach in the Mamas in Control Mastermind. You could check that out, momisincontrol.com/MIIC. But it's all about self-awareness and emotional intelligence, right? So for those of you who are listening, and there's kind of two types of the spectrum. We have the people that, you know, just go, 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 and burn themselves out. You're action takers, you're ambitious, you know, you can move the world, move mountains by yourself. And then you have the people who are not motivated to take action. Well, there's pros, right? There's pros and cons to both, but there's also a lot of similarities. So what I've found in my own personal life and my practice working with women who want to find that balance and alignment and ease and contentment in their lives, you know, they might still want to be ambitious, or they are ambitious, but they don't know what action to take. So the ambitious action takers, you know, you're the people that just burn yourself into the ground because of the body awareness, right? So your body, your mind are constantly sending you signs and symptoms, but you just have to be consciously aware enough to say, how can I read my body language? How do I know what's going on within me? Because signs of burnout and exhaustion are always there. It's just if you're paying attention. And this is why I'm such an advocate for journaling and understanding what is my soul craving. So I'm going to get back to my core message here, which is consistency is key. When you decide to become conscious, and what I mean by this is to live a more conscious life, what you are doing is you're choosing to take conscious action. And over the years, what I have noticed is, you know, there's something called the law of consistency, the law of momentum, right? So if I am going to, I don't know, your goal is to walk, this is very simple, your goal is to walk 1,000 kilometers in a month. I don't even know if that's realistic. I guess anything's possible, right? 1,000 kilometers in a month. And every day you walk, you divide that, okay, 1,000 kilometers, there's 30 days in a month-ish. I'm going to divide that by 1,000 divided by 30. What is that? I don't know, because I can't do the math in my head. And all of a sudden you're like, okay, I need to walk 5 miles a day. I don't even know if that, I said kilometers. Anyways, let's just say it's 5 kilometers a day, right? So you're doing your 5 kilometers a day. This is really bugging me. Now I need to do the math. 1 second. Okay. So I'm doing the math on my phone as I'm walking, recording this podcast. 1,000 kilometers a month. That's your goal, right? Divided by 30. Oh God, I was way off. Okay, 33.33. So let's just round it up. 33. No, we'll just do 33 a day. So this isn't an unrealistic goal that I set for myself, because I didn't plan what I was going to say on this podcast. So consistency is key, guys. Your big goal, 1,000 kilometers in a month. I'm committed. I'm going to walk 1,000 kilometers in a month. Random goal, just made this shit up, not actually going to do it. So what do I need to do? I need to, well, I got 30 days in the month. There's 1,000 kilometers I need to run. I'm going to divide that by 30. And I just told you, I'm just going to round it down a little bit. So it's 33 kilometers a day that I need to walk. Okay. So consistency is key to reach your goals. I need to walk 33 kilometers a day in order to reach my goal of 1,000 kilometers a month. That's it. Consistency is key, right? So what I might else have to do is actually walk 33 kilometers and say, oh my God, this is way too much. I can't do this, right? It's taking me forever to do this. Like, I have a life. I can't do this. Okay, cool. Maybe my goal is 1,000 kilometers in 3 months, or 1,000 kilometers in 6 months. Or by the end of the year, I want to walk 1,000 kilometers. I need to stretch out my goal a little bit more or make it more realistic. Great. I need to walk 2 kilometers a day, right? I've stretched it out so far where I need to walk 2 kilometers a day. Well, cool. Okay. That takes me 20 minutes or 10 minutes or whatever. That's more manageable, right? So consistency is key. The reason why I'm telling you this is because I decided to sign up for another half marathon. I know. Don't ask me why I did this. The last one I did was 3 years ago. That was after I was free and clear of cancer. And you know what they say, what you resist persists and grows bigger. And just do the shit that scares you the most. Well, I've always had this ache, and I talk a lot about this. I had this soul ache. And what is a soul ache? Oh, wouldn't it be nice if, yeah, but I can't, right? I was always like, I want to run a half marathon. I just want to say I've ran a marathon in my life. So after I went through chemo and everything was good and clear, my health was back on track, I was committed. I'm like, if I can fucking like die and come back to life, I can run a half marathon. This is not going to kill me. So I signed up for it. I committed to it. The training was awful. I pretty much just like showed up every day and like hated life, right? And then I showed up and I was like, I just want to get to the finish line. I don't even care. Ran the race, did it. And it was more of like to be able to say I ran a half marathon, right? So I said I would never do that again. It wasn't fun. It didn't feel good. I didn't really have any like aches or pains or injuries. So when I decided to do, you know, I had this little ache, this little tiny voice inside of me that said, run another marathon. And I was like, no, I don't want to run a fucking marathon. Like, that was awful. I'd rather like do a cycle or something. But this little tiny voice. So I'm getting to the point of this message. Consistency is key. So this big, scary goal, right? Run another marathon. Like, I don't want to. So I sign up. I invite my friends. I'm still scared, nervous, whatever. I start my training. Talk about upper limit problems, right? This is what you think, what you believe will manifest. Then I get knee pain all of a sudden. I'm like ready to train, start running, get knee pain. I'm like, oh, fuck, I'm not going to be able to run, right? It's my unconscious beliefs like totally manifesting physically and trying to keep me safe. So I'm like, nope. So I do this reflexology, go to fascial massage, get all this magical shit rubbed on me. Pain is good, sustaining the pain. So then I check in with myself and I'm like, Heather, your tendency, your go-to pattern is to be all or nothing. This is me. I will move mountains and make shit happen, but my natural tendency is to like burn myself out. So I'm so far removed from that person I used to be, but I know that that's my natural tendency, so I have to be extra mindful of it, which is probably why I enjoy running a marathon. Well, secretly enjoy it. So consistency is key. 2 kilometers a day. Remember when I was using that ridiculous analogy of 1,000 kilometers? Well, I was like, okay, I don't need to abide by the half marathon training program that I would print off online. And then I'm like, oh, fuck, I got to run 4 miles today or 4 miles tomorrow. And then I just won't show up, right? Because I'm like, I don't have the energy for this. I don't want to do it. I'm going to talk myself out of it because mentally, I'm not there yet. I'm not there where I can just get up and go. I can do it with a group of people, but I don't want to be dependent on other people to have to get me to run every day, right? So my goal for this week is to run, and it was last week. I did it. I accomplished my goal last week, is to run 2 kilometers a day. That's it. That's all I have to do. 2 kilometers a day. It's long enough to get me up and moving, a little sweat going. And it's like, okay, cool. I did my little jaunt, right? So am I, the half is in October. I still have lots of time, but consistency is key. And I'm going to tell you what I've observed since I implemented this last week. it's created momentum in all other aspects of my life. So instead of being all or nothing in this like stop start energy of like, woohoo, I'm so on board. Oh God, now I'm not. Woohoo, I'm so on board. That's fucking exhausting, right? So imagine like you're trying to get from here to somewhere else and you have this long road trip. And you get stopped by every single red light. And there's a red light like every kilometer. That's going to be really annoying, right? You're going to start picking up speed and then you're going to stop dead. Picking up speed, stop. Pick up speed, stop. So imagine that all you have to go, you have to drive slower, but there's no stoplights from here to your end result, right? From here to wherever you want to go. You're going to get there. It's going to feel more flow, more ease into it. So this is a perfect example of energetic time management and energy management. An energy leak could be, I'm so scared, I don't want to do this, oh my God, right? All the stress hormones that are going to flood through your body, and then you show up to run the fucking 4 miles that you're terrified to run, or the 8 miles, or whatever, and then you run it, you're like, woohoo, I did it. So then you're on this high of like you actually accomplished something, and then you have this big letdown. Well, what if you just consistently show up and take one action a day? And then once you get that momentum and you're like, okay, I'm not really challenged with this anymore, you just do that one action plus some to push forward, to make it easy for you. Ease with a little bit of challenge, right? Ease with a little bit of force, a little bit of resistance. This is how we push that glass ceiling. This is how we make magic happen in our lives. And talk about magic. I'm walking and I stop and look at a tree and there's a woodpecker. And I've never been this close to a woodpecker in my entire life. Like this woodpecker is a good 10 feet from me. And I'm just watching him peck on the wood. How freaking cool is that? This is what I mean, guys. If I wasn't going on my walk, if I wasn't doing my... Oh my God, it's so cool. If I wasn't doing my 2 kilometers a day, I wouldn't experience the magic. I wouldn't have seen that woodpecker up close and personal. So be mindful. What do you want to challenge yourself to do? Who do you want to become? Don't worry about the big end goal. Don't worry about what you want your business to look like. Don't worry that you want to be out of debt. Don't worry that you want to quit smoking. Don't worry that you want to lose 100 pounds. Don't worry that you want to cultivate a relationship with your children or your husband that you never think you're going to be able to accomplish. Don't worry about that. Just ask yourself, what do I need to do today? What's one simple action that I can take today? And take that one simple action. Take it consistently for the next 7 days. Consistently for 7 days. Same action, consistently. And watch as things slowly shift in your life, as they slowly manifest, your mindset changes. Doors open up for you. That's it, guys. That's all I have for you today. Consistency is key. And apparently, if you want to walk 1,000 kilometers in a month, you're going to have to walk 33.33 kilometers every day, FYI. All right, guys. Talk soon. Oh,
Anything could happen. Anything could happen. Anything could happen.